Hi student friends, today we will discuss in second lecture, in continuation with our first lecture towards introduction to organic chemistry, that is cleavages of bonds. So here any chemical reaction involves bond breaking and making process. So cleavage of chemical bond leads to the formation of chemical species or fragment species, and this is called as bond fission or bond cleavage. It is caused by electronic redistribution, and which is gain or loss or withdrawal of share or lone pair electrons by an atom in a chemical species. There are two types of bond fission. First one is homolytic bond fission, which is also known as homolysis, where symmetrical or even breaking of covalent bond takes place to form a free radicals, and therefore it is called as homolytic bond fission or homolysis. So what happens here? Each one of two atoms withdraws its shared electron and leads to the formation of free radical, that is pair of free radicals. So as movement of one electron takes place, it is represented by half-headed or fish hook arrow. For example, homolysis of methyl bromide. So what happens here in methyl bromide molecule? Methyl group and bromine atom undergoes symmetrical cleavage in presence of heat and light, and follows homolytic cleavage, where they leads to form methyl free radical and bromine free radical. So overall, in homolysis, carbon-bromine bond is broken in such a way that both atoms, that is carbon and bromine, get one electron each, which is shared for covalent bond formation. So this type of homolytic cleavage occurs in gas phase in presence of heat or in presence of ephyllite, as well as in peroxide. Therefore, this type of organic reaction which proceeds via homolysis are also known as free radical or non-polar reactions. Second type of bond fission is heterolytic bond fission, which is shortly abbreviated as heterolysis. So how will we define this fission process, that is unsymmetrical or uneven breaking of covalent bond, which leads to formation of oppositely charged ions, that is nothing but heterolytic bond fission or heterolysis. So simply what we can say is that both atoms, they get shared electron, and of that either one of two may get two electron. Therefore, it leads to formation of ion pairs, where there may be deficiency in the electron density or electron rich behavior for ion may occur. As movement of pair of electron occurs, it is represented by double-headed arrow. For example, we may take here alkaline hydrolysis of methyl bromide, which is also known as SN2 reaction. So what happens here? OH minus, which bears extra negative charge on it, is given to this carbon, which is connected to bromine, and this bromine is more electronegative than carbon. Thereby, it polarizes this carbon-bromine bond, and carbon bears positively charged, and therefore it is attacked by negatively charged OH minus and leading to the formation of methyl alcohol as a final compound, where bromine is released in the form of bromine minus. So overall, reaction takes place in solution phase, in presence of heat, and by using polar solvent, where electron redistribution may take place and it proceeds via heterolysis, and therefore it is called as ionic or polar reaction. Thank you.